Hey everybody, this is Jerod. I'm here going to do another reaction video. We're going to continue our trek through the sing-off with Pentatonix. This is their third performance. It's going to be Peace of My Heart by Janis Joplin. I really like that song, but I also know Pentatonix kind of, judging by the first two performances, make it their own. So I'm actually going to look real forward to this one, see what exactly they do with it. And I can, like I said before, they're really growing and you're seeing them take those criticisms to heart. So here we go, without further delay. Consider liking this video and subscribing if you like what you see. And stay tuned, because we're going to continue on this journey as we progress and ultimately see them win. So here we go.
I love the 60s. I think I was born in the wrong time.
We are not from the 60s, but we've been doing our research.
Was Woodstock in the 60s?
Yes.
Was it Jimi Hendrix?
Yes.
Was The Who in the 60s too?
Yes.
Yeah. We love James Taylor, Dusty Springfield, and Sam and Dave.
It's an incredibly rich experimental time because the rules got kind of thrown out the window. You're not playing standards anymore. You're inventing a new sound.
1, 2, 3, 4.
In the 60s, you didn't have the digital technology that we have today. You didn't have autotune. It really relied on voices. A lot of recordings were just one takes.
North Shore definitely has an advantage because they're the only ones that were around in the 60s.
We're the grandparents, and we have been singing since 1965.
Back then, you had to just sing. You couldn't do any effects.
This is our style of music.
We should be able to knock this out of the park.
That's somewhat true.
You guys suck.
Kind of.
Yeah, man.
All you guys suck.
In the 60s, it's such a fun, free-spirited, energetic time. And I think it really actually lends to the Ayers style a lot.
Our group has never, ever done a 60s song before. But I know that we'll be able to pull this song together and really work hard. I mean, maybe.
Step. Body better.
I'm pretty sure you're right.
Back when I was in college, I sang in the same a cappella group with Sarah Bareilles. One of the songs in our rep was I Want You Back, which incidentally is the same song Sonos is doing this week.
Uh-oh.
It's totally different from the original and from the way we did it then, so I hope she gets a kick out of it.
The 60s were an innocent time. I think that the audience will go back in time and remember how hopeful the 60s were, and maybe we can get some of that hope back again.
We'll start it off with a five-person group that packs a punch with ultra-modern pop. Now they're reigniting a tune by a fellow Texan that set the 60s on fire. Performing the classic Peace of My Heart by Janis Joplin, here's Pentatonix.
Here we go.
Come on.
It's got a good groove. Nice. This is awesome. And each time I tell myself, well, I think I'm enough. Yeah. I'm gonna show you, baby, that a man can be so tough. I need you to come on, come on, come on, come on, and take it. Take a little piece of my heart now, baby. Oh, yeah, break it. Break another little piece. What's Avi doing, man? He's moving way more vigorously than the rest of them. A little jazzy there. Yeah. Tap another little piece of my heart now, baby. You know you got it if it makes you feel good. Stuff's getting dirty with it. I really like that. That was a good groove to it, man.
All right. Nice going, Pentatonix. I know. Nice. I feel good. Sean, you feel good?
I would have never thought to arrange the song that way, but it, nope, actually it came out real fly. Give it up one time for the flugelhorn. Come on, man.
That was really cool.
Kevin, that was off the hook, man. That was great. The reggae feel and all of that was just a really great bonus to obviously a great record. Janis was an awesome vocalist, and you know, she had that grit and that grind when it came to her singing, and it was awesome. The way you guys spun it was a stone groove, my man. It was off the hook. I loved it.
All right.
That's cool.
What'd you think?
I was hoping I would fill up this page with all sorts of notes, and I just was like, you know, just staring at you guys, giddy the whole time. I thought that was great. I, like Sean, I didn't expect the arrangement to go that way at all, and I thought that was a really cool, smart choice to sort of put this song into a place where you guys could really sort of make it your own. I love that phrase. You made it your own, man.
All right.
I thought, Kevin, you killed it, both on trumpet or flugelhorn.
Flugelhorn.
Great, I love it. I thought you had a great groove. And I think you guys have just a really great blend. I think at some point I was kind of missing the powerhouse of your other arrangements and choices, but it's so great to know that you're versatile, and you did it really well.
Well done.
When you don't know how to finish what you're saying.
Well, my favorite musical groups take risks, and sometimes they bust their ass, and sometimes they do a great job, which is what you guys just did. That was great. Like, you nailed it that time. So I hope that you keep taking risks, because sometimes you miss and sometimes you don't, but it's so much more interesting when you nail it. Every once in a while, you guys want to rush, and this time it wasn't very often. But there was a moment that you could have slowed down a bit, and that was on the come-ons. Could have just waited a little bit to give us a downbeat, and I think it would have won there. Avi, great bass singing. His deep voice sounded awesome. Overall, it just really worked. You didn't stay precious to the 60s version, and it won for you that time. Yeah. Nice work.
Okay. Very nice.
We'll find out soon if you're moving forward. Thanks, Pentatonix.
I really like that.
When we come back, two more vocal bands go retro on back-to-back 60s classics. We're one step closer to the elimination on The Sing-Off. Want to go behind the scenes at The Sing-Off? Check out NBC.com and follow internet sensation Sam Shuey as he takes you up close and personal with all our groups.
Oh, that'd be so cool. I wish that could have been me. I would go back. I'd hang out with him. Make it cool. Okay, so I liked it, of course. You heard me throughout the video. Kind of couldn't hold it back. What I saw this time was a lot more... they stuck to the plan. And then they committed to it in a way that was really cool. I liked the groove. I liked the way they were dancing. I liked the way they were keeping it rolling. And it kind of had reggae and kind of jazzy feel to it. It was really, really nice. And I liked the way Kevin did the flugelhorn, as Sean said. One thing I'll say is that I can see where they get their skills and everything that they do now. They've taken a lot of these criticisms to heart, and it really shows. It shows how moldable they were, and that they weren't so into themselves that they refused to hear criticisms or coachable moments. Sometimes if we take it with a grain of salt and just kind of listen to what people are saying, you never know how great you can actually be until you start trying some of the things. Maybe some of the things they say will work. If it doesn't work, then toss it out. But I really appreciate Pentatonix for doing this. It really makes me, it encourages me to keep going and working through criticism. So Thank you all for another great reaction request and everything. Keep commenting, keep listening and everything like that. And we'll catch you later. Bye.